Thank you, co-facilitators and colleagues, for this opportunity to share our views. I will deliver my statement on behalf of the local authorities measure group. I am thankful to all my colleagues for the strong cooperation in producing this joint statement. The zero draft outcome documents offer a clear picture of the universality and ambitions of the agenda. Nevertheless, it could further emphasize the role and contribution of stakeholders in implementation, follow-up and review based on a people-centered approach. Bearing in mind the lesson learned from the MDGs experiences, addressing inequalities within countries and ensuring no one will be left behind are fundamental aspects that can be translated into the identification of gaps and specific needs of communities and territories within each country. The zero draft should recognize the diverse array of local circumstances. In the same direction, the challenges and possibilities found at the urban scenario should be further strengthened in the text, especially in paragraph 26 of the declaration, in line with the agreed topics of the SDG 11. It should reflect the relevance of cities and territories to deal with the crucial elements of the agenda, as combating poverty and hunger, improving health, education, resilience, and other interconnected themes of sustainable development. All of that should ensure inclusive cities integrated in their territories. In this context, local communities and civil society should explore all possible mechanisms to convey their voice and needs, and local and subnational governments can be a channel to ensure political will and commitment to those. Considering this, we would like to ask member states to consider the inclusion of the subnational level as a fourth sphere of the follow-up and review section, in addition to the national, regional, and global levels already included. This would improve the framework and ensure coherence with the interagency expert group on SDGs indicators. In the sake of territorial cohesion and improved participation, existing mechanisms at the subnational level can complement the efforts of national governments. The Charter could recognize existing mechanisms at all levels, for example, local and subnational council of sustainable development, or among the others, the experience of the province of Potenza, the Italian local authorities of subnational level, recently being acknowledged by the UNISDR as a world role model for its inclusive action on territorial resilience, developed in coordination with its 100 cities and also communities. National platforms should also facilitate the involvement of civil society, ensuring inclusiveness, accountability, and ownership of the agenda. For all the above reasons, the local authorities measure group welcomes references to local and subnational authorities in the zero draft and call for their recognition as direct partner with shared responsibilities and to further engage all the stakeholders in the process. Detailed input and language suggestions have been submitted through the stakeholders consultation form. Thank you.